All this would suggest that Britain's answer to rap music has become a permanent fixture on the pop landscape, just like hip-hop culture did in the 1990s, after roughly the same period of gestation. But look beneath the surface success, and talk to people in the scene, and there is uncertainty. It was even implicit in the Wireless Festival. AJ Tracy performs in the Y Extra Live Lounge. A thrilling new generation of rappers and MCs are emerging, but most of them are just not making grime. The last-minute cancellation of Sunday night headliner DJ Khaled raised a pertinent question, as the organizers scrambled for a local replacement. Which artist could plausibly be within a few hours' reach of London on a Sunday morning, with a stature to carry such a headline slot? Apart from Stormzy, Wad already headlined, Skepta Wad headlined in 2017, or his crew boy Better Know Wad headlined in 2016, and the end Canadian superstar Drake, who happened to be in London, stepped into the breach. But grime's lack of strength in depth is notable. It's hard to envision who from the UK grime scene could fill such a slot that hasn't already done so. A thrilling new generation of rappers and MCs are emerging, but most of them are just not making grime. Young West Londoner AJ Tracy, who came up through the underground as a grime star, making grime music, caused consternation earlier this year when he told Esquire in a landmark interview, "Don't call me a grime artist." Hotly tipped teenage lyricist Dave has appeared on one or two grime songs, but is very much in the classic rap mold, more like Streatham's answer to Nas. Brummy missed and North Londoner Mostak, who delivered a show-stopping performance together at Wireless, and the supremely talented Jay Huss, are creating a much slower, more melodic sound, a fusion of Jamaican dancehall, West African Afrobeats and rap, which some are calling Afro-swing.